Of course, you see the signs everywhere. Jay-Z is answering the call. Jay-Z has confirmed that he will be performing at Madison Square Garden on September 11th. The show is to benefit the Answer the Call, the New York Police and Fire Widows and Children's Benefit. Tickets will go on sale September 8th. Now, because Citi is a great, proud sponsor of this, pre-sale at 9 a.m. for Citi card holders. General public at 12 o'clock. Now, the great thing about this concert, another Jay idea, he said, I want all the tickets to be the same, whether it's the first row or the highest row. So at $50 per ticket, if you get your ticket first, you could be sitting in the front row or you could be sitting in the high row. So I would guess that it's best kept if they got their tickets first. Be a first responder. 100% of the proceeds, again, an idea of Rock Nation and Live Nation, 100% of the proceeds will go to the charity. All 100%. So everybody's doing this out of serving. Nobody's saying, oh, you got to give me a little bit of this. Oh, I need this. Everybody's serving. The concert will air live on our good friends, The Fuse, with our good friends, The Fuse, at 9 p.m. Eastern on the 11th. I don't want to forget, and I'd be remiss to say, Jay, again, is going in on Blueprint. So Blueprint 3 will also be in stores then. And, of course, this is number 3. And Jay, we've done a lot of great things together. Again, I think this is going to be one of our greatest acts. And without further ado, I'd like to introduce Jay Marciano to come and say a few words.
Thank you, Kevin, and thank all of you for coming out this morning. On behalf of Madison Square Garden, we are proud to host native New Yorker Jay-Z and proud to be part of Answer the Call. As many of you are aware, Madison Square Garden has a long legacy of hosting historic benefit concerts that have supported important causes and recognized events that have affected us all. Whether it was the 1971 benefit concert featuring George Harrison with the Concert for Bangladesh, or from the Big Apple to the Big Easy following Hurricane Katrina, or the Concert for New York City, which featured, amongst other giving and talented performers, Jay-Z. The Concert for New York City was a celebration of strength, resilience, and pride of New York, and raised more than $33 million for charities dedicated to helping those mostly affected by the events of 9/11. And today, artists like Jay-Z continue to ensure that the sacrifices of our first responders never forgotten, and that as New York community, we continue to remember the families who are left behind. Today, we are pleased that MSG will not only host this event in the arena, which kicks off the Absolute Concert Series, but we will also televise it live on our national music network, Fuse, which will help provide a national stage to raise awareness for this important cause. Now, for those of you that keep score, throughout his young but prolific career, Jay-Z has already sold out Madison Square Garden 7 times. In fact, his 3 sold-out performances in 2008 rank in the top 10 grosses of all time at Madison Square Garden. And yet we have no doubt that it will be his 8th performance that will become his most unforgettable yet. For this will be the performance that he was remembered not only for his music, but for his message. So Jay, on behalf of Madison Square Garden, we welcome you as an artist. We welcome you as a businessman, and now we welcome you as a philanthropist. Thank you.
It's a privilege to be here today. We were so thrilled when we got the call from Jay-Z and Kevin and Lior Cohen and his people to see if we'd be interested in being the beneficiary of this wonderful event. And certainly we're humbled to be considered in that fashion. Let me just take a minute or so to tell you about our organization. We have a singular cause, that is to provide economic and human support to the widows of those who have paid the ultimate sacrifice protecting our city. Now, we've been doing this for 25 years or so, we didn't start this yesterday. Originally, we were dedicated to supporting the widows of the police department and the fire department. And then after the events of 9/11, we expanded our reach to help those widows of first responders from the EMS and from the Port Authority. So, as I said, we've been at it for quite some time. We've worked hard to raise our visibility and enhance our network of supporters, and we believe that with the support of Jay-Z and all of the sponsors that you heard about from Kevin, we should be able to further enhance that visibility. We've distributed more than $100 million over the years to the widows, and we have approximately 700 widows and their children that we're providing benefits to. So you can understand when we make an immediate payment upon the death of a first responder, or we provide an annual stipend, you can begin to grasp the size of the monies that are necessary to make a difference. We believe it's important as a civilized society to make a difference in the lives of these widows, to make sure that they understand that we haven't forgotten the sacrifice that their loved ones have made. And that's why we're so appreciative to Jay-Z and all of the sponsors for helping us make a difference in the lives of these widows. Thanks very much.
Thanks very much, Kevin. Well, it's been 8 years now since terrorists attacked New York City and caused such terrible devastation and loss of life, 343 members of the fire department in an hour and a half. And while the fire department has rebuilt its ranks and is now stronger than ever, for our members, the pain lingers, and for, of course, those families who lost somebody, it will never go away. And that's why, to the fire department in particular, to the city, as a whole, it means an awful lot that Jay-Z will hold a benefit concert for the fund that has been helping our widows and families and all the first responder widows and families for 25 years. It means that the city's not forgotten about the firefighters and all the rest of the first responders that rescued 25,000 people on 9/11 from those burning buildings. And it means that the spirit of service is still very much alive when Jay-Z donates his time and his talent to an effort like that, like this. It also means that a lot of young people will be made aware of the significance of that terrible day. I have to say, on a personal note, I have to confess to Mr. Carter that as someone who grew up on Frank Sinatra and Perry Como, I'm not sure I'm his demographic, but after getting to know him a little bit, certainly going to the concert, maybe I'll become a convert. My kids assure me that I will. So,
you know, after the 9/11 tragedy, there was really a sense for a while in our borough that maybe people shouldn't stay and fight and rebuild. There was a sense that it would be easy to move to New Jersey or leave town. And much to people's amazement, folks here wanted to stay and fight. They wanted to protect this borough, and they wanted to rebuild the neighborhood, especially in Lower Manhattan. And we also wanted to connect with the people who gave their lives, went into the buildings when people were trying to get out of those buildings, and they were really the real heroes, the people who gave up their lives so others could live. That was back then. Years later, people to come together to step up and do this concert, to bring everybody together to say we are never going to forget what happens, and we are going to honor and protect the widows and the orphans, the people who don't have family as they would 8 years ago, I think is the greatest gift of all. Jay-Z, somebody that David Patterson and I, the music we listen to, Commissioner, because that's how we roll, but I'm just saying there's life after politics, you don't know. But seriously, someone like Jay-Z could be doing so many other things, not focused on this. And today we do salute you as a great musician, but now we salute you as somebody who is great for this city, great for this borough, and for every widow and orphan, the only thing that comes to mind is God bless you. Thank you very much.
And next up, our good friend, Governor Patterson.
Good morning. I'd like to thank everyone who is being associated with this great concert that we will see on September 11th. to the president of the New York City Police and Firefighters Widows and Children's Benefit Fund, Jay Danhauser, for all that he has done, for everyone that has been part of this event that will come off very shortly, to all of the executives here at Madison Square Garden who are helping to produce this great event, and to my colleagues in government, Borough President Scott Stringer, who said that for no charge at all, he will perform with you, Jay-Z, if you like. And also to Commissioner Scarpetta. Usually, I would want to sit in the front row, but if he's coming to the concert, I want to sit next to Commissioner Scarpetta, because I want to see this for myself. But, and also to the fantastic Kevin Lyles, who is kind of a drum major for all of these great events. Thank you for allowing me to come and talk about September 11th, 2001, a day when we lost 343 firefighters, we lost nearly 3,000 citizens, we lost many, many police officers, people who were willing to trade their space on this planet so that others may live. In just an hour or two, the most steadfast, disciplined, collective dedication of people trying to save others that perhaps we've ever seen. And to know that a benefit concert will be held on September 11th, on the 8th anniversary of that tragic day, by one of the world's great performers and also one of the world's great philanthropists, a person who has great business acumen and personal sensitivity, none other than Shawn J.C. Carter.
Hey, you guys, good morning. Thank all the guys on the panel for being here, for putting this together. I especially want to thank Kevin Lyles, because the idea is not anything without execution, so he put this whole thing together, so I want to give him a... Give y'all a brief history of how this all came about. September 10th, 2001, I was in Los Angeles shooting a video for Girls, Girls, Girls. My album was to come out the next day. And I got a phone call, and a friend of mine said, turn the TV on. And I turned the TV on, and I saw the World Trade Center on fire. And it looked like a movie to me. It didn't look like anything that it could be real. So the last thing I was thinking about was an album. The first thing I thought about was what happens from here, like, you know, what happens tomorrow? How is this whole thing is gonna continue? And I was in Los Angeles, was there anything I can do? And I turned on the TV September 12th, and I saw footage of these heroic actions, people running into buildings and saving each other, and I just saw the strength of New York, and it made me proud. So as I was, you know, embarking on putting out this Blueprint 3, it was only right to revisit the day, and this is my chance to do something to help out. So I thank, this was a little shaky, I thank all these guys up here for helping me see that vision, Kevin Lyles and the governor and everybody, and I really appreciate this, and we're gonna have a great time, and bring your earplugs, because it's gonna get loud. Thank you.